Hi, I'm G, and in this video, we're going to be working through an electric field problem due to point charges, and ultimately find the electric force. Here's the question. Let's go ahead and take a look at the picture. So we're given three point charges here. I'll just label them in order, charge 1, charge 2, and charge 3. And first, we have to get a visual representation of what these electric fields look like. So we'll start with charge 1. We know that positive charges create electric fields pointing away. So I'll label E1 here. And for charge 2, we know it's negative. That implies that the electric field is going to be pointing towards it. Here's E2. And then lastly, charge 3 is also positive, so it's going to look similar to E1 in its electric field, E3. Now, in order to get the overall electric field, we need to treat these electric fields, individual ones, as vectors. So we must combine them into their component parts and look at the x and y directions. So in the x direction first, we take each one individually. So E1 has its x component along this axis here. And this angle will again be 30 degrees, matching these. So we see that E1 in that x direction is the magnitude of E1 times the cosine of that angle 30. So we have E1 magnitude cosine of 30 degrees. Now looking at E2, we see that all of it is in the x direction, however it's pointed to the left. So we're going to subtract the magnitude of E2 in our overall x component. And then lastly, E3 is going to be treated similar to E1. We'll take the magnitude of E3 times the cosine of 30 to get that x component. Cosine of 30 degrees. Then, to complete this, we keep in mind that the electric field due to point charges is equal to Coulomb's constant times the value of that charge divided by R squared, where R is the distance between the location of the charge and the location in space you're talking about. So using this, we find that the overall x component is K times the magnitude of Q1 all over R squared times cosine of 30 minus K times the magnitude of Q2 all over R squared plus K times the magnitude of Q3 all over R squared, and again a cosine of 30. Now we know the values of Q1, Q2, and Q3 given in the picture, and R is also given as 4.12 centimeters, and K is Coulomb's constant. So multiplying these out, we'll have 9 times 10 to the 9 Newton times meters squared over Coulomb. And then Q1 we know is 3 nanocoulombs, so that's times 10 to the negative 9, all over R squared, 4.12 centimeters is times 10 to the negative 2 meters squared times the cosine of 30. Minus, plugging in the values for the rest, we should get that the overall electric field in the x component is 16,900 newtons per coulomb. That's EX. Now, there will also be a Y component to this electric field because E1 and E3 have Y components to them. So taking the Y component of E1, we see that it's pointed down here. And it's going to depend on the sine of 30 rather than cosine for the X component. So this is the magnitude of E1, sine of 30 degrees. And we said it was in the negative y direction, so we'll put that negative out in front. And now the y component of E3 is in the positive y direction, so we'll add magnitude of E3. And again, it's going to depend on sine of 30 degrees. Then we refer, as always, to our electric field due to point charges. And we see that this is negative k Q1 magnitude over r squared sine 30 plus k magnitude of Q3 over r squared sine 30. And then we get fairly lucky, because if we look at the charges Q3 and Q1, they're exactly the same, meaning that these two values here cancel out without us having to plug in any number. This is equal to 0 newtons per coulomb in the y direction. So that lets us know that the total electric field is just the x component, 16,900 newtons per coulomb in the I hat direction. Now for part B of this problem, we suppose that there is a new charge, I'll call little q, equal to negative 5.05 nanocoulomb at the location of the point P where we found the electric field in part A. And we're asked with finding the force on this charge due to the configuration of those three. And all we have to do is remember the relation between electric force and electric field. And that is that the electric force is equal to the charge we're considering times the electric field at its location. So plugging and chugging, we see that the electric force is just little q, negative 5.05 times 10 to the negative 9 coulombs, times E, which we found was 16,900 newtons per coulomb. And this ultimately gives a value of negative 8.55 times 10 to the negative 5 newtons. That's the force that this charge little q feels at this location P. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.